Hello, my name is Keshwani. That is K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today we'll have our vocabulary lesson number 77. Let's get going, shall we? Let's get going. The very first word we're going to learn is subscribe. If you would excuse me just for a second, I think I want to get rid of this marker, otherwise I'm going to keep on picking it up. What does it mean to subscribe? Subscribe, of course, everybody knows the primary meaning. It's a very simple word, which means to buy, to sign up a contract to get a newspaper or a magazine. That's the first meaning. Everybody knows it. To sign a contract to buy a newspaper or a magazine. Just give me one second, I'm going to throw this away, otherwise I'm going to keep picking it up and it's going to be very annoying. I am not going anywhere. I'm still here. Now it's out of the way and I won't keep picking it up all the time, you see. What's the other meaning of the word subscribe? It has two meanings. Another meaning of the word subscribe, if someone says I subscribe to it, whatever it might be, means that they believe, it means to believe in a certain idea, a certain thought, certain theory, a certain notion. If you believe in certain idea, listen, I know my handwriting is atrocious, but it really shouldn't have the right to complain, because I always read everything that I write. So as long as you're paying attention to what I have to say, my writing is actually should not be a primary concern, because I always read it as this. So here we go. It means to believe in a certain idea, certain thought, certain theory, or certain notion. So if someone says, no, I don't subscribe to that school of thoughts, I don't subscribe to that school of thought, that means I don't believe in that. They talk about this particular theory, they talk about this particular way of doing things, I really don't subscribe to it. That means I don't believe in it. I'm not buying it. I'm not into it. Do you understand? So subscribe means to buy a contract, to have a contract, to buy a magazine or a newspaper. That meaning, of course, is a primary meaning. Everybody knows that meaning. This is another meaning. Let's move on. A new word which has nothing to do with subscribe or subscription, entirely different word, okay? And the word is going to be bombastic. Bombastic. An adjective. What does bombastic mean? Bombastic means a loud pretentious, pompous speech or writing. Loud, pretentious, pompous, usually it is speech, or it could be writing. You can describe a piece of writing as being bombastic, or you can describe a speech as being bombastic, which is full of grand gestures and promises, but devoid of substance. When we hear the adjective bombastic, typically politicians come to mind, because politicians have a tendency to go around giving speeches, especially when they're running for the office, when they're campaigning. We will do that and vote for me and this will happen, and yes, this will happen, we can do this together, we can achieve this. this is full, it's a land of opportunity and this and that. They make huge, they make grand gestures with their hands and arms and so forth. They make grand promises, but when you really pay attention to it, it's all devoid of substance. It's just rhetoric. Such a speech is called a bombastic speech. Such a speech is called bombastic. It's loud, it's pretentious, it's very pompous. Now the reason why you see the word pretentious and pompous in capital letters is because these are words we have already learned. Pretentious is the word we learned day number 68. And this is also day number 68. It's very important that you watch this series in its proper sequence, because once we have learned certain word, I just take it for granted that you know them, because of course we don't have a luxury of going over the same words over and over again, so I'm going to leave it at that. It's a loud, pretentious, pompous speech. If you don't know what pretentious and pompous means, or if you want to learn them properly, day number 68 is where you need to go. Just type in vocabulary words, day 68, along with whatever test that you're preparing for, it will pop right up. Just type in GRE vocabulary words, or GRE vocabulary words, or GMAT vocabulary words, or TEAS, or HESIs, or SAT vocabulary words, day 68, and it will pop right up. Let's keep on going. Another word, which is a synonym of bombastic. Where can we put it? I left myself no room at all. Let's do it here. It's too low. How do we pronounce this word? Let's find out, shall we? Grand deal eloquent. Grandiloquent. What does it mean, grandiloquent? It means exactly what it says. If you dissect it, if you break it up, it has two parts to it, prefix and suffix, obviously. Grand means big, of course. And eloquent, it means speech. There are many words in English language which this root, which means to speak. Grandiloquent means a grand speech, a bombastic speech. I'm not going to rewrite the definition, but that's what it is. It's a synonym of bombastic. That's all there is. The noun is grandiloquence, grand speech, bombastic speech. Let's move on. Another word which is going to have this suffix here, locution, that is, locution means to speak, which is where words like eloquent come from. The next word we're going to learn is circumlocution. Circumlocution. Circumlocution is again a very straightforward word. If we dissect it, we can immediately see what's going on here. This word here, locution, means to speak, and circum means around. Circum means around. Of course, circum means around because that's where the word circum is where the word circumference comes from. That's where the word circle comes from. Circumference means to go around, circumference, distance around the circle. Circumference has the same root as circum. Circumlocution means to speak around and around and around and around the subject. I ask you a very simple, very straightforward question to which your answer is going around and around and around, but you never actually answer my question. You're beating around the bush. You're dodging the question. Circumlocution means to dodge the question, to beat around the bush, to evade the question. To evade the question, or as I said, to dodge the question to avoid telling the truth, to avoid telling the truth. Of course you don't want to tell the truth, which is why you're going round and round and round, never getting to the point. You never get to the point because you don't want to tell me the truth. I ask you a simple question, you're not answering me. You're beating around the bush. To beat around the bush is an expression, to beat around the bush. To beat around the bush means never getting to the point, going round and round and round, but you will never answer my question. Politicians are very good at that. You ask them a simple questions. Of course they don't want to give you an honest answer, because honest answer is something that nobody wants to hear. So they engage in circumlocution. They go around and around, they give you a long-winded answer for 10 minutes, but at the end they haven't answered what you asked them. Understand? Very simple question was asked, is the project going to go over the budget? Straightforward question. This project that you're talking about undertaking, is it going to, or the project that you are in the process of doing, this bridge that you're building or the school that you're building, is it going to go over the budget? And to which the answer comes, of course we want to make sure that we use the finest quality of material that we use. We don't want to jeopardize the safety of the children, and we want to make sure that we do it the right way, so that we have to do it over and over again. It goes on and on for 10 minutes, but he will never answer your question. He's engaging in circumlocution, and it doesn't have to be he, it could be she. There's another word which has the same prefix, circumspect. Circum means around, and spec is where the words such as spectacles comes from. Spectacles, your glasses that you wear, or spectators in the match, in a stadium. A stadium is full of spectators, onlookers, watchers, people who came there to watch the match. They call spectators. Spec is the suffix here, which means to look. To look. So what does it mean when you are circumspect? Literally, it means you're looking around. Literally means you're looking around. You're paying attention to your environment. You're very wary of what's going on around you. You're very cautious. To be cautious. To be wary of your surroundings. Of your surroundings. Of your environment. And the reason why you're very aware, very wary of your surroundings, is because you're very careful. You suspect some sort of a danger or some sort of a negative things that might happen to you, and you're very careful as to what's going around you. You're always looking around from the side of your eyes. You're circumspect. You're very careful. You're very cautious. You're very careful, very cautious. That's all. It means to be very careful, to be very careful, to be very cautious, to be very wary of your environment, to be very wary of your surrounding. And the word was circumspect. By the way, this is a repeat word, this is not a new word. This is the word that we learned on day number 23. The only reason I mention it again is because it just came to my mind. Circumlocution is what the word we were talking about. Circumlocution has the same prefix as circumspect. Since we are back to circumlocution, let's take a look at it one more time. Circumlocution, we said literally it means to talk around and around and around. You're evading the question, you're dodging the question, you're not giving a straight answer. And when you behave in such a way, a couple of prefixes we learned long time ago, they come to my mind. It means, circumlocution means to prevaricate. Prevaricate. This was day number 27. To equivocated. This was day number 26. To qualify. To qualify a statement has a different meaning than to qualify for a job. Qualify, the word qualify has two meanings. Of course, you know the first meaning, everybody knows the first meaning. Well, what does it mean when you say, he gave me a qualified answer? He was asked a very simple question, and he gave us a qualified answer. What does it mean? Well, you're going to have to watch the video, because as I said, we cannot keep repeating the same words over and over again. Do you understand? When somebody asks you, when the parent asks a child, did you do the homework? Did you do your homework? Did you do your homework? And the answer is, well, yes, of course I did my homework, but as soon as you hear the but, the parent might snap and they'll say, and the parent might say, listen, I'm looking for an unqualified answer. I'm looking for what kind of answer? I'm looking for an unqualified answer. I'm looking for an unqualified yes or a no. That's all I want. I want an unqualified yes or a no. As I said, when you watch the video, you'll know. Day number 27. Let's keep on going. So that was circumlocution. Let's move on. Another word which has to do with speech, and the word is loquacious, which means simply to be talkative, to be talkative. If you're talkative, you talk a lot. You talk and talk and talk. You all the time. You're talking. You're flapping your gums constantly. Such a person is called loquacious. 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 It has three syllables. Loquacious. The noun is noun of loquacious. This is adjective. The noun is loquacity. Loquacity. Let's learn one more word, shall we? Simple word, related word. The word is it's pronounced garrulous, garrulous. Some people pronounce it in this way, and some people pronounce the word with a Y sound in it. Garrulous. Garrulous. With a Y sound in it. Garrulous or garrulous, which means talkative, loquacious. They're same. They're synonyms. So I'm not going to rewrite the meaning. That's the synonym. It just means habitually talkative. Somebody who talks a lot. Somebody who is habitually, as I said, talkative. Let's move on. We're going to learn the next word, which has absolutely nothing to do with talking at all. We're done with that topic. We're going to move on to something entirely different, okay? Here we go. Milieu. Milieu. It's a French word. It's not milieu, milieu. You see? O and the E are joined together. Milieu. What does it mean? It's a noun. Milieu is atmosphere. Surroundings. Environment. If you say that you do not care for the particular surrounding, particular atmosphere, particular environment that you find in a given restaurant, if you don't care for the surrounding, the environment in that restaurant, you say, I don't like the milieu of that restaurant. Or you might like to go to that restaurant. Well, I know the food is not very good. I know the food is not great, but I love the milieu. I love the settings. I love the way they have set it up. I just like sitting there. I just like having a meal there, even though the meal itself may not be very good. I love the milieu. I love the atmosphere. The word is milieu. Let's learn one more word, which is related to milieu, but not quite. Which is not quite. And the word is simply, and in this word, this is milieu, but here, when it appears by itself, it's pronounced simply as lu. Lu. And it is used in an idiom typically, and the idiom that you will hear is in lieu of, which means instead of, or in place of. Do you understand? He had borrowed $1,000 from me, and he was unable to repay his debt, so I made a deal with him. I said, why don't you give me your car? He was trying to sell his car for $1,000. He owed me $1,000. Why don't you give me your car in lieu of your payments? Instead of paying me $1,000, which you're unable to pay and you're trying to sell the car, I'll just accept the car in lieu of your payment, in lieu of your debt. I'll just accept your car in lieu of your debt. Michael could not go to the board meeting, so he sent Jennifer in lieu of him, instead of him, in place of him. Do you understand? If you cannot use that one in lieu of whatever it is that you're using. It just means instead of, it just means in place of, in lieu of. The very last word I'm going to talk about is actually not a word in English language. It doesn't exist in English language. It's a French word. There are many, many French words that do appear in English language that are used on a regular basis in English language. But the next word actually you're not going to find in English language because it's purely a French word. But we're going to learn it anyway. We're going to learn it nonetheless. Because it's related. Let's put it on the side here. It's not actually a separate word. You'll never see it in any of the exams here, GRE, GMAT, anyway, because it's a French word in its purest sense, and the word is bon Dieu. As you can see, it also has the same suffix, lieu. Bon Dieu is just a suburb. Outskirts. Bon Dieu is where the French people tend to put all their people who are underprivileged, people who are minorities. They build them these high rises, 20 stories, 10 stories, 30 stories high rises in the outskirts of the city, in the suburbs of the cities. And the banlieue is where you will find them. And if you live in the banlieue, that's not a good idea. You understand? Because you're basically cut off from civilizations, because the metro will not take you to downtown. If you want to go to downtown from banlieue, you probably will have to change three trains. You see? Bye now.